Hi, my name is Dexter Clark from the Netherlands, and in this video we're going to take a look at how to upload HD, so 1080p or 4K footage on YouTube. And it doesn't matter that much if your video is in 4K or in 1080p, the upload process is exactly the same. There are several different ways to upload 4K or 1080p footage to YouTube. You can click over here, for example, in YouTube Studio, but you can also click over here, create and select upload videos. Then the upload dialog will appear. You can click on select file and then select a file from your hard drive, or you can drag and drop from your file explorer to this window over here. And that is what I'm doing right now. Then the video detail dialog will appear. Over here you can fill out the details like your title and make sure that the character limit stays within 45 to 50 characters to prevent truncation. I've made a video about how to make viral video titles that get the click. The link is in the description below. Then fill out your description, because the description tells the YouTube algorithm, hey, this is how you can find the video. So describe what is happening in the video. For example, this video is about feeding dogs. If you don't know what to put in your video description, I also made a video about that, and also that link you can find in the description. Then over here, it will show a preview of the video once the upload is finished. When we scroll down, we have the thumbnail over here. You can upload a custom thumbnail. I would highly recommend you to make a custom thumbnail and upload that here. Click on that icon and then click on the image file. Over here you can set to which playlist I should add the video, for example the first playlist over here, or you can even search for that, for example every video. Then over here, this is a very important setting: audience. Is your video made for kids, yes or no? This is a legal thing. If your main target audience of the video is kids, then you have to select yes, it's made for kids. There are some options over here, but those are not that important that will make a dramatic difference in your video performance. So I will leave them amongst that is the tags, for example. And yes, there are still people that think that tags work. That's absolutely not the case. If you're in doubt, I also will link up my tags video in the description below. Then over here, we have the tab monetization. We're now in details. We're going to monetization over here. If you have a small channel, you are not monetized yet, this tab will not be here. And I select yes, I want to monetize this video. Then you will notice that an extra tab shows over here is ad suitability. I will not going to get much into detail here. I would like to get to the next tab. I can click on the tab or click on next. I click on the tab. This is the self-certification tab. Is your video suitable for advertisers? In my case, all my videos are saved, so I can check this box, none of the above. I click on next, or I can click over here. In this case, I click on next. Now I can add video elements. This is grayed out at the moment because the upload is not finished yet, so I can't add them right now. In order for the upload to finish, you need to make sure that this tab and your browser is still open, otherwise your upload will be cancelled. At any time you can click over here, then it will still upload the video, because on the bottom here it shows you a progress. And when we go to content, you can see the video over here. But I don't need to wait for this to finish. I can click on edit draft and I get the screen we had before. It says upload complete now, processing will begin shortly. This processing can take a while, and the SD processing can take up maybe half an hour, maybe an hour. The HD version can also take up an hour or two, and the 4K version can take up to 4 hours or so. Now the processing of the SD version is completed, and that's all we need to get to the video elements. Now you see all these elements are enabled. We can add an end screen, and when we click on add, then we get the end screen editor. We can import the last video, one video, or we start with a blank sheet like over here. Then we can click over here to plus element, and we can add a video, a playlist, a call to action to subscribe. We can add a channel, we can add a link, and we can add merchandise. I click on video and I can choose between the most recent upload or the best for viewer. I can add another element, for example, another video, then for example, the most recent upload, or I can choose a specific video, for example, this video right here. Over here is the timeline, and I can shorten or lengthen the duration of these end screen elements. When I click over here, this is the end screen element, this is the end screen element over here. I can shorten it this way by just clicking on it and dragging. When I'm happy, I click save, and over here I can add cards. Click on add, and over here we can again add videos, playlists, channel, or a link to a website. I click video, for example this video, and this is my timeline over here, and I can drag this bar thingy, over here, and now it is added to this point in the video. I can add a custom message if I want to, and I can add a teaser text, for example test, and then it will change to test over here. I click on save when I'm happy. Now I go to the visibility tab. I have a couple of options. I can say make private, unlisted, or public. Private, nobody can see it unless I add them specifically. Unlisted is just if you have the link, then you can watch the video, and public is public for everyone, and every video you see on YouTube is public. Or you can choose schedule, and with schedule, your video is private until you select, for example, 29th of January at 3:15 a.m. When I click on save and publish again, with these three options, if you would select public and hit save, then your video will be directly available to everyone, except in this case, the HD version isn't processed yet, only the SD version. The 4K version isn't processed yet. That means if your video goes live now, that viewers won't be able to see the HD version and won't be able to see the 4K version. So I would wait until this processing is finished and then hit public, or use the schedule function. In this case, I'm using the schedule function, and now I click schedule. I guess if you're here, you're new to YouTube, then check out this playlist with beginner tutorials right here. And I also think you will like this video a lot. Subscribe to this channel if you want to get notifications for deep dive tips, tricks, and tutorials for YouTube.